The drones prove the effectiveness very much, but still have disadvantages. Today on City Tank Channel, you will know how to make the best suicide drone or loitering UAV, aka UAS, using current technologies. And note, this weapon could change the course of the current war. What you need is just to swap several parts. Some of these parts are even affordable off the shelf. But first, let's point the pros and cons of existing UAVs in comparison with the other types of conventional weapons, such as artillery and tank shells, ATGMs, aircraft bombs, rockets and missiles. First are the pros. Number 1. Cheap or rather cost-effective. Number 2. Lighter weight. Number 3. Lower thermal and sound signature. Number 4. Default top attack ability. The pros are somewhere linked with the cons. Number 1. Low jamming immunity, especially when operated in non-line-of-sight mode. Number 2. Bad repeatability of the specifications. Lighter and slower drones are more dependable on weather conditions. Number 3. Parts incompatibility. Most of drones has proprietary launchers, batteries, warheads, etc., even when produced by the same company. Number 4. Lower speed. Enemy crew can easily change position during UAV flight. Number 5. Short range if battery powered. But being powered by combustion engine, drone has bigger sound, thermal and radar signature, and thus is more vulnerable to interception. So, how to avoid all these negative factors and turn the same class of drone into a perfect weapon, like ATGM but more silent, with longer range and even more dangerous to enemy air defense and tank active protection system? Step 1. We should solve this dilemma on propulsion. Of course, electric motor is better in the most cases. For example, record-breaking all-electric plane made by Rolls-Royce reached top speed of 623 km per hour. But a combustion engine drone may have much longer range, up to 2000 km. So could we increase endurance using electric motor? It's hardly possible with lithium batteries. Instead of it, we can use at least 3 variants of energy system. Variant number 3 in our list is hydrogen-powered suicide UAV. It has thrice more endurance than lithium batteries. Yes, I know, hydrogen is explosive, just what we need. Remaining fuel could give an extra blast effect to a UAV attack explosion. And even more, carbon fiber composite cylinder that stores hydrogen provides extra rigidity to fuselage, increasing payload ratio. Less total weight, more warhead mass. Of course, hydrogen energy system is not as robust as combustion engine, but there is a better solution. Number 2 variant already exists in defense industry, but in rather different domain. It is silver oxide aluminum battery. It had been already used for a long time in torpedoes, such as MU-90 produced by Naval Group. Aluminum silver oxide seawater closed-loop battery provides twice longer energy capacity than the closest competitor, including lithium-ion and LTO. But this is not the only preference of this battery type. It has aluminum anode and case. Nowadays, it's not the lightest material in aviation industry, but still widely used. So, aluminum structure will give more rigidity to the airframe, saving total weight. Moreover, aluminum is also used as bomb metal body material, and we could use the same airframe both as warhead case and energy system, turning almost the whole drone into a giant explosive battery. Despite inflammable lithium batteries, this type has much safer water-based electrolyte. Both aluminum and water are rather whiskers for being penetrated by splitters of airburst round, such as German ahead. If you find it rather complex and expensive, there is a more simple solution using only off-the-shelf parts. Variant number 1 is combination of ultracapacitors and lithium-ion battery. Ultracapacitor has much more density than any battery. It's more efficient, but the negative side is short time of energy release. Using one stack of ultracapacitors and lithium-ion cells connected in one electrical circuit, we can receive quite balanced energy system performing a long-range aka endurance. Ultracapacitors are the best for take-off, fast climbs and accelerations, complex maneuvers, and fast dive during attack mode. On the other hand, battery is more useful for a long time loitering in the same low speed, or even hovering, and recharging the autocapacitors between the surges. For those who are skeptical, please note, autocapacitors-powered buses already exist. One capable model is even able to run 20-kilometer route after 8 minutes of charge. As we determined about the energy system, the next step is the launcher. The smallest and most lightweight UAVs can be thrown by hand or launched with a handheld device, whereas larger aircraft will require a fixed-rail launcher. UAV catapult launchers may be pneumatic, hydraulic, or bungee-assisted. Both pneumatic and hydraulic launchers require heavy devices to operate, such as power supply, air receiver, and air compressor. But they have rather small dimensions, as drone is carried inside launcher. On the other hand, bungee-powered drone catapults are simpler, quieter, and cheaper, using energy stored in elastic cords, but much larger because of long catapult and UAV being launched with wings unfolded. I offer two solutions. The first is used in silent mortars. When firing pin hits primer, it explodes powder and expanding gases in closed volume retract telescopic cylinder in the rear part of the bomb, pushing it outside mortar. We just need to replace a rather heavy warhead body with a cap saber to install inside it the rear part of the UAV. Solution number two may be heavier but much more affordable. It is spring-loaded launcher. Similar mechanism were used in various weapons during World War II. Of course, in 21st century, we can assemble it much simpler and lighter. For example, to compress heavy spring faster and easier, we can use wire and roller block as it realized in Soviet AGS-17 automatic grenade launcher. To speed up loading, one may also add electric motor with a reduction box. To fit the launching canister, we should design a proper airframe, and it is step 3 in our list. There are many successful cylindrical drones unfolding into agile airframes like American Switchblade 600, Emirati Edge Hunter 2S, but as I think Israeli Eurovision Heroes 30 has the most fitting airframe, compact with more advanced airfoil. For better surveillance on targets, UAV may have a vertical hovering mode. We can add it by installing two unfolding counter-rotating propellers in the rear part. Of course, I know that tail-seaters failed, but main reason for it was landing problems. Suicide drone does not need landing. We can explode it after surveillance over any inhabitable area unless a strike needed. The same principle is used in Switchblade UAV family. Step 4. Long-range signal transmitting. First, we need to make a specialized signal-repeating drone, able to reach maximum altitude about 6,000 meters. We can use the same fuselage to install bigger lithium-ion battery and repeater instead of warhead. The battery is responsible to perform a low-speed long-time cyclic flight staying in the line of sight for the land transmitter. The connection distance will increase dramatically as well as the maximum range of strike. To see how to make more up-to-date types of weapons, subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching and God bless you.